In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Turn to me and have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am alone and poor. See my lowliness and suffering, and take away all my sins, my God. This is Tuesday of the ninth week in ordinary time. It seems a long time ago that I last wore green vestments, and indeed, with one thing or another, to go all the way back to February, was it? And it seems a world away. However, things are moving. We are moving. The church's year is continuing. It's one of those intriguing things that in the old calendar, this week after Pentecost was a week dedicated to prayer for the coming of the Holy Spirit. However, in our current calendar, we did all that before Pentecost, which is quite right. Now we have come through Pentecost, we are to live the life of the Spirit, to rejoice in the good things of God, and to fulfill the mission given to us. Filled with the Spirit, let us open our hearts to be renewed by the mercy of the Lord. Lord Jesus, you are the image of the unseen God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are the firstborn of all creation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the head of the body, the church. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, whose providence never fails in its design, keep from us, we humbly beseech you, all that might harm us, and grant that all works for our good, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of St. Peter. You should be living holy and saintly lives while you wait and long for the day of God to come, when the sky will dissolve in flames and the elements melt in the heat. What we are waiting for is what he promised, the new heavens and the new earth, the place where righteousness will be at home. So then, my friends, while you are waiting, do your best to live lives without spot or stain, so that he will find you at peace. Think of our Lord's patience as your opportunity to be saved. You have been warned about this, my friends. Be careful not to get carried away by the errors of unprincipled people from the firm ground that you are standing on. Instead, go on growing in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ. To him be glory in time and eternity. Amen. The word of the Lord. more than a watch in the night. O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next. Our span is 70 years, or 80 for those who are strong, and for most of these our emptiness and pain. They pass swiftly, and we are gone. O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next. In the morning, fill us with your love. We shall exult and rejoice all our days. Show forth your work to your servants. Let your glory shine on their children. O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next.
Alleluia.
And so we are back in the green. And green, of course, is the colour of growth. I'd like to say go and have a look at all the gardens around, except after an extremely dry May, I realise that my lawn and other people's gardens are beginning to look dried out and a bit straw-like. However, the principle is there, that as we move from spring into summer, we are seeing the growth of plants, of flowers, of fruit and veg. And I think that's quite important in these bizarre times to say that nature is asserting itself. And the nature of nature is to grow. So too for us. Our true nature is to grow in the things of God. God's purpose for us is that we grow, that we bear fruit, and that we blossom with delight and beauty. As we enter into the ordinary time of the church's year, may all our being be ordered by the love of God and ordered for growth in the things of God. Let us pray for God's church and for God's world. We pray for the people of God throughout the world. We pray for those thinking about how to respond to the next phase of our response. We pray for racial justice. We pray for the United States of America. We pray for our own country, that all people of whatever race may be valued and know that their lives matter. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. We pray for those who mourn. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we pray for the repose of the souls of those who have died, both those who have died recently and those whose anniversary of death occurs at this time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And we ask our Blessed Lady to pray with us and to pray for us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Loving Father, accept the prayers we offer through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Trusting in your compassion, O Lord, we come eagerly with our offerings to your sacred altar, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Saviour and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to stretch the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, We declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness.
Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the people,
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered in one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Vincent our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, but with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, with her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy
souls free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. I invite any watching online to make an act of spiritual communion. To you I call, for you will surely heed me, O God. Turn your ear to me, hear my words. Let us pray. Governed by your Spirit, we pray, O Lord, those who feed with the body and blood of your Son, that, professing you, not just in words or in speech, but also in works and in truth, we may merit to enter the kingdom of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is